how to do axe polygon modeling in Maya. By the end of this lesson, you will learn to create this axe model very easily. Just you will understand how to create this axe model very easily with all the tools you learned in the last 2-3 sections. You can also download this model if you want from simpleinfo.net. Let's start creating this model. In this lesson, I'm going to create something related to this. Based on this, I just drawn the basic sketch for the cartoon axe. And whatever you have learned so far, all the polygon primitives and mesh tools and many other tools you learned so far in the last previous 4 sections, you got solid idea. Now this is the first assignment we are going to do with little bit complexity, little bit our own creation. As usual, I want to start with the cylinder. Start with some cylinder, reduce the radius, get the basic shape first, select the right click, hold and click on vertices and something like this. This is a little bit cartoon form. Even we know we don't need these many axes actually. Even before doing this, we need to modify that. I want 8 so that it will be easy to extrude. Make little bit smaller here, little bit bigger here. And we want to insert an edge loop. Mesh tools, insert edge loop. And this is where we extrude the metal axe. And select the faces, both the faces, and extrude. Edit mesh, extrude. See, we are getting like this. Control Z, world or global mode, extrude this way. And scale them down. See, we got the, this is blocking phase. First we need to get the basic blockings. Scale them down like this and scale it up. If you want, you can, right now you can make it like this. Little bit down front, click up arrow to move to the next vertex. You see, once this is over, to get this roundness, we need to add one loop here and we need to pull this one, this vertex. Insert edge loop tool, just add in the middle. See this. Now select the vertices. See, this is a fundamental repetition. Adding the loops, then getting the shapes slowly. If you click 3, you will see in like the smooth mode. Right now don't bother, we will add the loops here also. Once if you add the loops here, automatically they will stay there. Insert edge loop tool. Now click 3. See, that is how it is holding. And one more loop I want to add here to get even roundness. Insert edge loop tool. It is better to use side view. Control vertices, scale them. We got this shape. Even we need to scale these little bit because in the center they'll be a little bit sharp. Click on 3. See, this is how we are getting. Still we need to add little few more loops. I want to add loop in this direction. Insert edge loop tool. See this. Now if you click 3, it's coming. Little bit round, little bit straight I want to do. Click on 3. Insert edge loop tool. Same process gets repeated. Loop flow, you need to understand the loop flow. See, I'm following the loop flow. Click 3. See, it is. You need to add one more loop here to make it sharp. Insert edge loop tool. One more here, one more here. Three. See, we are getting the shape. Select and scale. And click 3, it comes out this way. See, almost we are getting. You need to add the loops here and here. They will hold the shape. See this, we are getting this shape. I want to extrude this little bulge. Faces, select all these faces, and extrude. We should have done this previously, but no problem. We will attach these two. We will remove these faces. Delete. Delete. Merge vertices to center, merge to center. G is the shortcut for last user tool. G, see, I got it. G. Merge to center, that is what is G means. G. See, we got it. We are getting wonderful shape. Slowly. Click on 3. Even if to get very sharp edges, we need to add one more. Loops. Insert edge loop tool. Click on 3, so that is what we need. See this. W. And if you need some bulge, this one. You need to extrude the back faces. First we need to make it round, little bit round. Select this and make it round. Like this. Now extrude the faces. Control E is the shortcut you can use if you want. G is the shortcut for one more time. One more time, G. Something like this. Select all these vertices and scale. Then align single line. Say this. Click on 3. So we got the basic shape. As it is getting bigger, just this is a little bit extrusion. Insert edge loop tool 2 times. Transform the edge loop tool like this. Select the faces all. Extrude one more time. Offset edge loop tool. This time I'm using offset edge loop tool so that it creates in both sides of the three. When you click three, it becomes sharp. Make this sharp. See this? This is how to make it happen. The same thing you can do on the top. This thing. Insert edge loop tool. Vertices, scale, single line, scale. They will align in a single line. Select all the faces. Extrude out. Three mesh tools, offset edge loop tool, make it sharp. You go on working like this to create even I want to add little bit bending here, like for the insert edge loop tool 1, 2, 3. In the center I want little bit scale down. Like this. This is what an X model. We can extrude this and make it that one. I hope this is enough. You can do that. This is what we got from this tutorial. I hope if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel and share on your Facebook and Twitter social media walls. And if you have any queries, please comment below so that I can respond to your queries or doubts. Thank you.